ChatGPT has taken the world by storm. It's quickly become the most advanced AI in existence, to the point where it is actually being compared to Google, and the thought of replacing Google itself is one of the main reasons you are all here. Hi everyone, my name is Damulang, and in today's session, let's see what ChatGPT is all about. So firstly, let me welcome you guys to this session with this beautiful movie on AI.
One day the AIs are going to look back on us the same way we look at fossils.
Hello.
So guys, I want you to stick around and we shall discuss why have ChatGPT been compared to Google and why have people said it's going to replace Google. Now, but before we begin with this amazing topic, if you haven't already, then make sure you give this video a like and click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to get more amazing content like this. Also, if you guys are interested with any certification training, then do check out the link shared in the description box below. Now, there have been many movies on the rise of robots to show people how the world will look like if an AI surpasses the human being. However, now we are much closer to knowing with the rise of AI, and to be more specific, generative AI. So guys, what is generative AI? Put it in simple terms, generative AI is artificial intelligence that can generate new content rather than simply analyzing or acting on existing data. Perhaps in the last few weeks, you've heard more and more about OpenAI and the new product ChatGPT. Now, it's been trending on Twitter as well, guys, and has amazed over a million users in just 5 days, which is itself is mind-blowing, having launched on 30th November 2022. But guys, what is ChatGPT? Now, I'm pretty sure many of you all have heard about ChatGPT or OpenAI, right? So how does this revolutionary technology actually work? So here is how it happened. Now, generative AI has been described in the recent months as the most talked tech in the Silicon Valley, and OpenAI is right at the heart of it. Now, you might have seen their other programs at work like DALL-E. DALL-E, a text-to-image AI software that creates image based on written inputs. Now, I'm pretty sure you guys have heard about DALL-E 2 as well, which is a new AI system from OpenAI that can take simple text description like two robots dancing together and turn them into a photorealistic image that has never been existed before. Now, OpenAI, the business, was founded in 2015 by Sam Altman and, you have guessed it guys, Elon Musk as well. Musk stepped down in February 2018 to focus on Tesla and SpaceX, but he remains a donor and advisor to the business. Now, their goal at the time was to advance digital intelligence in the way that is most likely to benefit the humanity. Now, at its core, OpenAI is an artificial intelligence research business that has shifted from a non-profit to a profit, despite no longer working day-to-day at OpenAI. Elon Musk thinks that its latest program, ChatGPT, is scary good. But before we come on to the ChatGPT, it's important to note that it's not the first go at an AI chatbot. Now, you guys might have known Microsoft launched Day in 2016, but within the first 24 hours, Twitter users caught rude, racist, and misogynistic language, which led to its downfall. Similarly, Meta have also launched BlenderBot 3 in August, but again, it fell down for similar reasons, as well as providing false information, even to question like who became the president in 2020, suggesting that Trump had won the election that year. OpenAI is trying to avoid these kinks by employing moderation API. Now, what do you mean by a moderation API, guys? So, moderation API is a system that assists developers to show when things go against their content policies, like illegal or unsafe information. It's not 100% accurate, but it certainly helps, right? Alongside ChatGPT and DALL-E 2 is a GPT-3, which is a natural language system that can also write, argue, and code. Now, ChatGPT uses an upgrade version of this to create text at incredible speed, so that it brings us on to ChatGPT. What is ChatGPT? Now, that's why you all are here for after all, right? According to the statement from OpenAI, they have trained a model called the ChatGPT, which interact in a conversational way. The dialogue format make it possible for ChatGPT to answer follow-up questions, admit its mistakes and challenge incorrect premises, and reject inappropriate requests. ChatGPT is the third update to OpenAI generative pre-training ideas, which allow users to communicate with robots with seemingly natural dialogues. But its users doesn't stop there. As it corrects grammar, it summarizes difficult text into simple concepts, it converts movies into emojis, and it also fixes bugs in Python code as well, guys. So how powerful is this tool, guys? ChatGPT opened up the first beta testing in November 2021 through the Playground. And it launched this year is supposed to be an improvement on GPT-3 as to not provide any harmful outputs. The software itself has been trained by AI and machine learning with massive amount of text data from various sources. Now the training uses RLHF, which is reinforcement learning from human feedback. Now the newsletter from newscientist.com have also stated that top AI conference banned use of ChatGPT and AI language tools to write academic papers. Now the ABC News have also highlighted this point saying ChatGPT was banned from New York City public schools, device and networks. And you guys are all aware of Stack Overflow. Now Stack Overflow have also banned ChatGPT for constantly giving wrong answers. Now this all seems a bit true, and maybe it is. Now we have to think about not only the limitation of the technology, but also the challenges and the threat that it poses on society. Now the first immediate consequence of ChatGPT was that its own website had frozen due to massive demands. Now with more than a million people signing up to use the software in just 5 days, which is quite incredible, forcing OpenAI to quickly scale up their system. Now ChatGPT is still in its early stage of development, therefore its knowledge base is limited and mostly linked to 2021, which renders some question useless. Now when Elon Musk found out that OpenAI was accessing Twitter database to train ChatGPT, now he pauses the access because OpenAI is no longer a non-profit and open source, therefore they should pay for this information in the future. Now as you might expect, right, there are some ethical implications that comes with this type of chatbot, particularly around new videos that have surfaced where coders can use it to write their code and SchoolKit can use it to answer the exam questions. Some troublemakers have also shared how they were able to avoid the content moderation, forcing the bot to disable its ethical guideline, followed by a tutorial on how to make a Molotov cocktail. Now, further implication includes how people could be the target of generative AI, for example, deepfake videos, explicit content, or propaganda. Now, questioning user privacy, now this type of generative AI can also push people out of work. DALL-E 2, the text-to-image AI, has now been linked to Shutterstock, which has caused outrage given people now competing with AI to sell their photos online. But this doesn't just apply to photos. Now some are saying that ChatGPT's ability to generate human-like written text could see the beginning of the end of journalism, where others feel it lacked the ability of critical or ethical thinking skills that are required. The threat that ChatGPT poses to society might seem shocking, but these threats and challenges will also help OpenAI to fix loopholes and workarounds, which is why they've released the version to the general public. Now they've already said that some answers are incorrect because there is no source of truth in the data they use to train the model. Now sometimes ChatGPT complex and detailed answers can mislead people into believing that the answers are true. Sometimes though, you have to think of the positives, like people who run online businesses who can now use ChatGPT to help customers with live chat queries that don't take all day and feel much more natural. Now helping business owners to make the sales in spite of the limitations and concerns. Now many in the tech world see ChatGPT as a look into the future. Generative AI is the next era defining innovation, which will change how we interact with the internet. Now some think this is the end of Google. Now why scroll through ads when you can ask questions to ChatGPT and get an accurate answer? ChatGPT is free to the public, with many people suggesting that a future iteration which could include cost per questions. Now at some point, ChatGPT will likely have to pay for itself. Now we may see advert on future models, or they might be small microtransactions. Now, no one can predict the future, however, it could mean mass unemployment to anyone in the arts world, or it could be just a useful tool for students to cheat on their homework. Now, its impressive rise in just weeks has made it worthy of discussion, and the fact that it is already being compared to Google made it sound like a new revolutionary on the rise of the danger AI. But for now, it's more of a meme machine, and OpenAI seeks to understand what it can and cannot do. So whatever comes of this new age technology, we like to welcome you to the future. So guys, with this, I have come to an end of today's session. Now I hope you guys like the videos and excited to see where ChatGPT takes us in the future. Now if you guys are interested to learn more about ChatGPT, then you can go ahead and click the link shared in the description box below. Until then, happy learning and thank you guys.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to EduRica channel to learn more. Happy learning!